Thanks again for checking in as we take a look at that extreme weather outlook. And the western U.S. along with the Midwest dealing with some snowfall. Looks like the Midwest will see the snow developing later today and through Friday. Some kind of wrapping up there on Saturday as well. But California is dealing with some flooding, maybe some mudslides and critical fire weather conditions developing in the southern U.S. as well. Here is a view from Boston. The snow falling once again. Another big storm impacting the region. That's the fourth one since the beginning of March. New York City seeing some of the heavier tallies, and especially Long Island. But the nice thing about March snow is that it melts pretty quickly. The heaviest tallies that I could find was 19.3 inches Bayshore, New York, 19 inches as well. Wayne Heights in Pennsylvania at 16.8 inches. But there is the snowfall analysis. Again, you can see some of the heaviest falling in eastern portions of Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and even into Long Island. But 8.2 in New York City, 6.7 Philly, and 8.7 in Pittsburgh. Those were all good enough for daily snowfall records yesterday. Snow is basically wrapping up in the Northeast, but we had turned our attention to this winter storm developing a fairly narrow band, very wet, slushy snow, maybe 6 to 12 inches up into North Dakota, and then some 8 to 10 plus inch tallies in a very narrow swath from southern Minnesota into parts of the Midwest. So again, this will start to develop late tonight in North Dakota and eventually unfold in southern Minnesota Friday and into Saturday through the Ohio Valley. Meanwhile, we've had some very heavy rain in California. This is a shot from Montecito in the creek in California there. Some spots picking up almost 2 inches of rain. We're not quite done. A number of headlines have been posted from flash flood watches to winter storm warnings. And again, we may see an additional 1 to possibly 2-plus-inch rainfall tallies there. Some of the high elevations of the Sierra Nevada picking up some very heavy snowfall. On the eastern flank of that, some very warm temps and a number of red flag warnings posted along the Front Range of the Rockies.